I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In meditation this week, the topic we have before us is sanctification. What is sanctification, you might ask? Sanctification is the putting off of the old man and putting on of the righteousness of Christ. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new." Our sanctification is accomplished only by our identification with Christ in his death to sin and his resurrection to newness of life. Sanctification is of three dimensions: positional, progressive, and ultimate. The Bible said, all things become new. Your old habits must be put away for newness of God to take place. This general saying that old habit die hard, this can be helped through the quickening of the Holy Spirit. You die quick to old habits with the help of the Holy Spirit. You need to be led by God and His Spirit, as seen in Romans chapter 8 verse 14, saying, "For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God." There is a leading to become sons and daughters of God. Positional sanctification is that state of holiness imputed to the Christian at the moment of their conversion to Christ. And progressive sanctification is referred to the process in our daily life by which we begin to conform to the image of Christ. It is the process of becoming what we are in Christ. This involves the putting off of the old habits like lying, backbiting, spirit of jealousy, and putting on the Christ-like qualities of honesty, His mercies, God's love. Amen. Colossians chapter 3 verse 1 says, "Now that you are saved, what is the next thing in line? You need to start working out your salvation with fear and trembling." This is a progressive and it also continues. We need to work our salvation with what? Fear and trembling. Ultimate sanctification, this is the state of holiness that we will attain to in this life. But we will realize this when we finally be in the presence of God. Behold, we are children of God, and it has not appeared as yet what we shall be. We know that when He appears, we shall be like Him, because we shall see Him just as He is, as we can see in 1 John chapter 3, verse 2. The Bible says, "Be ye holy, for I am holy." 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 16. This is a commandment, and it has to be obeyed. Jesus said, "If you love me, keep my commandments." John 14, 15. Remember, the work of sanctification is made easy if you are thirsty and hungry for the infilling of the Holy Spirit. God, the Holy Spirit, will help in the purging of any filthiness in your life. Hear this: "I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and flood upon the dry grounds. I will pour my spirit upon thy seed, and my blessing upon thy offspring." Isaiah 44, verse 3. Note this: Jesus is the living water. If you are thirsty for him, he will pour his spirit into you to purge you from all uncleanness. Be thirsty for a pouring and for a purging to make you anew. John 14, verse 17. Say this prayer after me: "Lord Jesus, help me and disconnect me from every bad habit that I may be struggling with. Purge me with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Cleanse me with the blood of Jesus. and sanctify me with your word assurance in Jesus' name. Ensure you are led by the Holy Spirit to a Bible-believing church. According to Hebrews chapter 10 verse 25 that says, we should not forsake the gathering of brethren. Get hold of a Bible. Read it every day. Meditate and reflect on it daily. And it will start manifesting in your life and character each day. Pray every day for at least 30 minutes a day. Be a witness of the gospel to other people as well. Your friends, your family, neighbors, and so on. Tell them about how you get saved and how Jesus loves you. Matthew 28 verse 18 to 20. You are blessed. I pray the Holy Spirit will continue to help you through this journey in life. In Jesus' name. Bye. Thank you so much. This is much more improved than the first one. Thank you, Holy Spirit.